So we're getting ready. We'll be ready in just a couple minutes. Looking forward to class tonight. Hello. Be there in just a moment. Hi, Michael. How are you? You gonna do class today? Oh, hi, John Hickey. You gonna do class today? Can't wait to see that. Let's do it. All right. Hi, everybody. We're gonna start in like 3 minutes, so go ahead and get yourself comfortable, settled. If you have a yoga mat, blanket if you need one for Shavasana, but we'll just be starting in a couple minutes, okay? Oh man, Kevin, you doing class too? Come on, let's go, boy. Yeah, just a couple more minutes. Look at all these people joining on. How many of you guys are going to actually do the class? I double dog dare you. Day is going okay. It was sunny today, which was amazing. I'm so thankful for the sun every day that it's out. It just, even if it's cold, it's better than nothing, right? I'm going to take my sweatshirt off in a couple of minutes, but it's a little bit chilly. I couldn't figure out how to turn the heat on in here, so I think once we start the class, I'll get warmed up, as will you. Actually, this is a really lovely class tonight. It's about de-stressing, so I thought this was a very appropriate for class tonight. Hi, Nicole. I hope you can stay for the whole class. So hi everybody, my name's Heidi O'Toole. My spiritual name is Dalraj Kar, and I am a Kundalini Yoga instructor, and I am teaching at this fantastic studio in Lodi called Kingfisher Yoga. The owner, Carla, and my friend has just a wonderful space here, and it's so loving and comforting, and I can't wait until everybody can come back into this space and practice with us. But for the time being, at least we get to do this virtually. Couple of things about Kundalini Yoga. Everything's timed, so when you see me futzing around up here, it's not because I'm texting people, it's because I have everything set to a time. This style of yoga came over with Yogi Bhajan in the late 60s, early 70s from India, and he saw the need for people to chill and to find their inner peace, and the techniques used are very powerful. The class is set up a little bit differently than other styles of yoga. We always tune in, which is with the Adi Mantra, which is Om Namo Guru Dev Namo. And no, you don't have to know this, and if you continue taking class with me, you'll get to know it. But we chant it three times. And it's basically a connecting to the golden chain of teachers past and present. And it's basically talking about the teacher within. Then we do some breath work. We usually do different breathing techniques that you can use throughout the day. There are as many times as a former school teacher that I would go into the bathroom, or when the students were there, I would just take 3 minutes and do this breath work. Then we do a yoga set, Shavasana, and I always bring my gong with me, so you'll get a gong bath today. And in other styles of yoga, you're usually done after Shavasana, but in Kundalini Yoga, we do a meditation. And then at the end of every class, we tune out with something called Long Time Sun. And it's a song that, it's an Irish blessing, but it's really fitting it really ties everything in really nicely. And then instead of saying namaste, which a lot of other styles of yogas use, we say something called satnam. And satnam means I am truth. And it's basically just a blessing to everybody. So without further ado, let's come up sitting straight and tall. Hands will be on your knees. And if you would, close your eyes and focus internally at your third eye, which is in between your brow point. And then just start focusing in on your breath coming in and out of your body. And just kind of letting go of the other things that don't serve you. Maybe things are a bit stressful today, but you know what? For the next hour or so, let's try and let that stuff go and just really focus inside and focus internally. Making sure your heart is lifted, your shoulders are down, and your heart is lifted. Taking some long, deep breaths through your nose. Inhaling all the way down from your lower belly, expanding your rib cage, and then exhaling, and almost as if you're an accordion and pressing that breath back in. And please take a deep breath in through your nose. Hold your breath at the top and release your breath. Again, take another deep breath in through your nose. Hold your breath at the top and release your breath. And this time, let's breathe again. To begin, put your hands together at heart center and let's take a deep breath in. Posture. Hands will be on your knees in Gyan Mudra. And Gyan Mudra is where your thumb and your pointer finger are touching, and you create a flat plane with your hands. Our breath work today will be a segmented breath. So we will be breathing 4 segmented breaths up and 1 long exhale out. So it looks like this. It's fairly simple. It's all right, and as you're doing that, you're going to close your eyes, focusing internally at your third eye right here, making sure that you're sitting up straight and tall, and you have a light Jalandhara Bandha, which means a neck lock. So what you'll do is, it's almost as if somebody is pressing gently into your chin, so it creates this flat, like straight line. So if I have my neck like this, you can kind of see where it's kind of cricked here. If I press this in, it creates this really nice line all the way down my spine. And the reason I ask that you close your eyes is because when you're focusing internally, your mind has less of an opportunity to start being, I call it a monkey mind, where you start thinking about all the other things that you need to do or whatever, right? So sitting up straight and tall, like Jalandhara Bandha, closing those eyes, focusing internally at that third eye, and let's begin. 4 segmented breaths up. And 1 long exhale out. And keep up, keep those eyes closed. And keep up. I challenge you to try and take the tongue off the roof of your mouth and let it just kind of settle in your mouth, trying to release that tension in your jaw as you continue that 4 inhales up and 1 long exhale down. So 4, keep going, 4 long exhales up, or segmented breaths up, and 1 long exhale out has healing powers, energizing, and it's also uplifting. And I mean, I think we need that anytime, right? We need to be uplifted and focused at the same time, so keep up. Keep up, stay out of your thoughts. Focus internally at your third eye. Check in with yourself. Keep focusing internally on that 4 count up and 1 long out. Try and stay focused. If your mind starts to wander, bring it back to your breath. Really refocus in that breath. Help your breath make you focus. And keep going. You're doing awesome. And wherever you're at, take a deep inhale through your nose. Hold your breath at the top. Release your breath. Release your posture. And just bring your hands on your knees. And keep those eyes closed. And focus internally. See if you feel any subtle differences within your body. Maybe a little bit more relaxed. A little bit more grounded. Just take a subtle inventory of yourself. So our yoga set tonight is called Relieve, Relax, and Recharge. It's a fairly easy set. It's, like I said at the beginning, it's very lovely. For the first posture, we're going to be sitting in easy pose, and our hands are going to be at our temples. On our inhale, we're going to push into our temples lightly. Now, don't jam into it, but inhaling and push in. And on your exhale, you're going to release that pressure, okay? Super easy, right? Just make sure you're sitting up straight and tall, and I think the challenge might be that your brain starts to wander. So really, really try and focus internally, all right? So let's begin. Inhale, pressing into those temples. And exhale, release. And inhale, press in. And exhale, release. And keep that up. Stay focused. Try and keep the tongue off the roof of your mouth. Let that relax. And really allow yourself to to just be present in the moment. Inhaling up, pressing into those temples. And exhaling and releasing. And keep up. We're about halfway there. Continue that long, deep breathing. Keep those eyes closed. Focus internally. And just so you know, every Kundalini class is different. Keep going, but every Kundalini class is different. Some class is more physical, some is more mental, and some is a combination of both. This practice tonight is a little bit more mental as far as trying to keep your mind centered and focused. And it's a lot of breath work, this class. So keep up, we're almost there. And please inhale through your nose. Suspend your breath at the top and release your breath. Release. Put your arms down at your hands on your knees, please. The next posture, you're going to take your hands and wrap them around your neck. And once again, it's the same kind of idea, but we're going to try and keep our arms out, which could be a bit of a challenge, especially, I don't know about you, but I hold a lot of tension in my shoulders. So that could be a bit of a challenge, but that's okay because you've got this. So once again, on your inhale, you're going to inhale and press in to the sides of your neck and exhale and release that, okay? And let's begin. Inhale and exhale. Sitting up straight and tall, heart lifted, shoulders down, elbows out to the side. And exhale, closing those eyes, focusing internally at your third eye. Keep up. We're halfway there, keep going. Stay internal. Stay focused. Continuing that long, deep breath all the way from your lower triangle, your lower belly. Last 10 seconds. And please inhale through your nose. Hold your breath at the top. Release your breath. Release your posture, hands on your knees, and just close those eyes, focusing internally. Our next posture, again, will be in a seated posture, and this time, what you will do is you're going to bring your hands around your waist, and so just like you're grabbing on like this, right? Your fingers are in front, and your thumbs are basically by your kidneys, okay, as well as your liver. And once again, as you're inhaling, you're going to inhale and press in, and then exhale and release that. All right, sitting up straight and tall, shoulders down, heart lifted, and let's begin. Inhale in, and exhale, release, and inhale in, and continue that, and exhale, release. If your mind starts to wander, bring it back to the breath and back to the motion. Although it's a subtle motion, it's still like, it's there, right? And we're halfway there. Remembering that this whole set is about relieving, relaxing, and recharging. So sometimes in our busy world, even though it seems like we've stopped, we still have a lot of tasks that we have to do on a daily basis. And to give ourselves the opportunity to just sit and recharge our own batteries is so important, right? We have a million things to do, even if we're at home. One of my friends wrote on her page on Facebook today about how many things she did, and she listed them out. And we need to make sure we take time for ourselves to recharge and regroup, right? So that we can be the best for ourselves and all the people around us. And please inhale through your nose. Hold your breath at the top. And release your breath. All right, so our next posture, it's same sitting in a seated posture. We're going to put our hands in fists. And what we'll do is we're going to rhythmically tap our upper chest, all right? And as you're doing that, each time you hit, it's going to be an inhale, exhale. So it becomes this breath of fire. And breath of fire is rapid breathing through our nose. So it, without the fists, it looks like this. So as you're doing that, right, you create this rhythm and you're tapping your upper, your chest area, okay? Sitting up straight and tall, closing those eyes, and let's begin. So as you're doing this, just so you know, you're stimulating your lymph area and circulating the lymph in this section. And a lot of times our lymph system does not move on its own. We need something to move it along. So this is giving the opportunity for that lymph to move around in your body. We have a ton of lymph in our bellies, underneath our armpits, in our armpits, and in your chest. So it's really a good idea to do this on a daily basis, moving that around. So keep going, inhaling and exhaling powerfully as you're doing that. Breath follows the motion. Keep tapping it out. It's almost like this whole set's kind of like you're giving yourself a massage for a lot of it. Keep up. Close those eyes. Keep that breath going. Stop the motion and take a deep inhale in and exhale. Just sit there for a moment and once again check in with yourself. Feel how you feel. So like I said before, we also have a lot of lymph in our belly area. So once again, you're going to take those fists and we're going to be at our navel point and we're going to once again tap. And as we're doing that, breath and fire as well. Okay, so the rhythm, same rhythm, breath and fists are in the same rhythm. Okay, so sitting up straight and tall, and let's begin. And keep up. Moving that lymph around. Keep up, you have about 30 seconds left. Another really interesting thing about Kundalini Yoga is that normally the teacher does not do the class with the students because we want the students to have the experience, but of course that's in the classroom setting, right? But once we're doing live videos, it's a little bit different. So I try and stay engaged with the teaching, but also to just model what you're supposed to be doing as well. All right, and stop that motion and inhale. And exhale. And the next posture, you're gonna be hitting the inside of your thighs and on top, okay? All right, and easy peasy, right? Let's begin. Once again, the breath is the same. So do the motion with the breath. Strong breath of fire. Take a deep breath in, stop the motion, and exhale, and once again. We're going to be taking our fists and our kidneys, we're going to be not punching our kidneys because that's not good, you're going to lightly hit at your back, and your kidneys are approximately right here, right? So you're just going to once again tap lightly in that section. Your breath is along the same lines as you're hitting. So once again, still breath of fire. And let's begin. Now, if you're having problems doing breath of fire at the pace that you're lightly tapping your kidneys, then slow the pace, right? You don't want to be short of breath, but breath of fire is an important breath, right? To regulate and to really move your energy and your breath throughout your entire body. And keep up, we're almost there. Please inhale and exhale. And just sit there for a moment, closing your eyes, focus internal. Just long, deep breathing. All right, so the next posture is called frog. And frog is an interesting little thing. You start like this. So your your heels are touching. Your feet are off, like you're almost on point, if you will. Your fingers are in between your legs and they're on the ground. And your legs are out at like a 45. On your inhale, what happens is you inhale and you keep this position in your feet, right? So your heels do not touch the ground. And the intent is, this doesn't happen, but your intent or your visual is to try and touch your head to the ground. So it looks like this, inhaling up and exhaling down. And when I exhale down, I look up, okay? So we're gonna do 21 of these and I'll count. Now, if I'm going too fast, I like to do my frogs kind of fast because I do, but if you need to take them slower, please do this at your own pace, all right? And if everybody's ready, let's begin. One, two, four, seven, 10. Ten, and one more, and stay there, and inhale, and exhale, and for just a moment, just come in to rock pose, just sitting on your heels for a moment, and just take some long, deep breaths. Reconnecting with your breath, smiling maybe, or not. All right, so our next posture is, we're gonna have our hands in penis lock. So that's basically interconnecting our hands. Gentlemen, your left thumbs are on top and your ladies are right. Our arms are gonna be up like this the whole time, but we're standing up. So, and this is in crow pose. So what'll happen, now there's real and ideal in this one. Ideally, you wanna get all the way down, right? And then come all the way up, all right? And arms are straight up over your head. That's the tricky part. And we're gonna do 21 of these. Now, no, I'm not watching you, so I can't see whether or not you're doing these, but let's do our best, okay? So everybody, and let's begin. One, two, three, four, down at your side, inhale, and exhale, and come down to a seated posture for a moment, and once again, close those eyes, and come back to your breath, and once again, like I said, this is so much easier when I just have to teach it and not try and do this as well. All right, so we're almost in the home stretch. Our next posture, what we'll do is we're gonna sit in easy pose. Our hands are gonna be interlaced behind our neck. And if you have long hair, you wanna make sure that your hands are skin to skin, so skin and touching neck. And what we'll do is we're going to literally lower our head down to the mat and then coming back up, all right? So once again, we're gonna be doing this 21 times. So I will count, but once again, I might be going faster than you. So do this at your own pace, okay? And here we go. And here's my last one, and one. And please take a deep inhale in. Hold that breath at the top. And exhale, release your hands down on your knees and close those eyes. And go internally. So we have two more postures. Tonight's class is a little bit shorter than a lot of classes, but that's okay. So we're going to hug ourselves, all right? And what we'll do is we'll inhale down and exhale up, and then we're just basically going from left to right, okay? So, everybody ready? Give yourself a really lovely hug, and let's begin. Inhale left and exhale up. Keep up. Halfway there. And please come to center and inhale. Hold that breath at the top. And exhale, release your hands on your knees, close those eyes, focus internally. All right, on the last posture before Shavasana, we will be lying on our back. And you can either have your arms at the side of yourself or underneath your bum or your hip area. So whether you're like this or like this, it's up to you. Your head will be down, and we'll be bringing our legs up to a 90 degree angle and then bringing them down. Okay, everybody ready? And let's begin. Inhale up and exhale down. Do this with control. Maybe with a smile on your face, or maybe not. Halfway there. Yeah. Last one, inhale up and exhale down and bring your legs down, arms at your side and inhale. Hold that breath and exhale. And what I'd like you to do is set yourself for Shavasana. So if you need a blanket, go ahead and grab that. But as you're sitting there, making sure that your legs are out, straight out, arms are at your side with your hands facing up, and just go ahead and take this moment and this time to really relax and focus internally, okay? And just kind of let yourself settle into the ground, and with every inhale, inhale, and just bring in that breath. And on the exhale, release yourself to the ground.
Thank you.
begin to start taking some deeper breaths, awakening your body. Encircle your ankles and wrists in circles. And then reverse those circles. Bring your arms up over your head, stretching away from your body, like you're giving yourself a good morning stretch. And now bring your arms out into a T on the ground. Leave your left leg straight. Bend your right knee and place your right foot on the floor. Fold over to your left and look to your right. And then reverse that. Right leg straight, left knee bent. Fold over to your right and look to your left. And then come back onto your back. Bring your feet off the ground and take the soles of your feet together and the palms of your hand together and rub them together. You're awakening about, 4,000 meridians in your body like this. And now hug your knees into your chest and roll 3 or 4 times on your back and come up to a seated posture. All right, so our meditation tonight is called Stress Relief and Clearing the Emotions of the Past. So please bring your hands, your fingertips together, right? And bring those to your heart center. And your fingertips are pointing upward. Now we're gonna sit up straight and tall with a straight spine. And our breath tonight, what it'll be is you're going to inhale for 5 seconds, hold for 5 seconds, and then exhale for 5 seconds, which seems fairly easy, right? Closing those eyes, focus internally at your third eye, sitting up straight and tall, and let's begin. Inhale. Hold. And exhale. 2, 3, 4, 5, and continue. Hold and exhale. And continue at your own pace, inhaling. And keep going. So this meditation, keep up, is especially useful for dealing with stressful relationships and with past family issues. It addresses phobias, fears, and neuroses. It can remove unsettling thoughts from the past that surface into the present. It can take difficult situations in the present and release them into the hands of infinity. So keep going. Focus internally at your third eye and keep your thoughts on your breath. Inhaling for 5. Holding for 5, and then exhaling for 5, and keep up. This meditation is also very good for lung capacity. You hold in that breath and exhale, and being mindful of the counts. It really helps to focus in on that breath and strengthens your lungs. Continue sitting up straight and tall, making sure your shoulders are down and your heart is lifted. Really feeling that breath. Please inhale, hold your breath at the top, breathe in a little bit deeper, and exhale, Release your hands down to your knees. Keep your eyes closed. What I'd like you to do is to take one more inventory inside. See how you feel. Do you feel any subtle differences in your body? So I always like to, before we tune out, I like to read A Year Without Fear by Tama Keeps. It's 365 Days of Magnificence. And this was written a couple of years ago, but it's so interesting how each one of these still has some merit even today. So April 16th. It is the 16th today, isn't it? Yes, it is. I want to help destroy your old stories. I don't care what got you here. I care about where you will go from here. I care about how much you will reach for what you desire with faith, intelligence, and fortitude. I want you to love your dreams more than your reasons for not having them. Today, I let go of one old story or several that hold me back. So we all have stories, right? We all have a past, but we all have a future. And what we are doing right now does not define who we are in our future. It helps to make us realize what we know to be true and also what we want for our future, right? And I think it's really important to think about that, to think about, I let go of one old story or several that hold me back. Our stories do not define us. And at the end of every Kundalini class, we tune out with long time sun. And I realize that most of you don't know it, and that's okay. But just listen to the sound vibration, all right? And I thank you so much for coming to class. And please bring your hands together to heart center. Close those eyes, and let's breathe to begin. May the long time sun shine upon you. All love surround you, and the pure light within you guide your way on. May the long time sun shine upon you. All love surround you, and the guide your way on, guide your way on, guide your way on. Sat Nam. Peace to all, love to all, light to all. Once again, thank you so much for coming to class. I hope you had a great time. And if you have any questions, please make sure you post them underneath. If there's something you don't understand about Kundalini, or if you have questions about it, I'll be more than happy to answer them. And until next week, blessings. See you later.